What's up, YouTube? Welcome to Pipes and Guitars, where I like to talk about my two loves, pipes and guitars. So, very special episode of Cracking the Tin today. I have a new pipe. I did an unboxing when it came in, and I'm gonna show you that now. What's up, gang? Got company coming over in just a few minutes, and got a very special box, which I don't think I can wait to open. So I'm gonna go ahead and open it out before company gets here. Some of you know I did my humanities presentation. I was chosen as humanities instructor of the year. That came with a little bit of a cash award, and there's a pipe I've always wanted called the Savinelli Lancillotto 320. Lancillotto meaning Lancelot, so it's modeled after the knight of the round table, Lancelot. So the shank looks like the hilt of a lance. Really cool pipe. I've shown you guys before, but I'm fixing to do a quick unboxing here before our company gets here so I can smoke it tonight. Can't wait. So you guys won't get to see me smoke it for the first time, but you will get to see it unboxed for the first time. So I hope you enjoy it. Here we go. All right, got the knife. We're gonna cut down. Very excited to open this. Opening her up. Packing paper. Lots of packing paper. My box. Well, this looks like a different Savinelli box that I've seen in the past. Just gonna kind of cut through this. I'm not sure. I think this is one of the nicer Savinelli pipes. It was surely one of the more expensive that I bought. Yeah, so it comes in a different Savinelli box. Oh, wow. This is nice. Check out the box. It's got those little Savinelli crest on it. Really cool. On the bottom there. Savinelli right there. Lancillotto. Smooth. There is a sandblasted version of this. Okay, got that. Take that out. Oh, they really covered the pipe well, and that's great. Thank you for that, Smoking Pipes. This is from smokingpipes.com, by the way. All right, I gotta be very careful not to injure the pipe. Okay. I've got it by the bowl. I'm gonna try to pull it out of this. Here we go. 2, 3. Oh. Man. How gorgeous is that? Look at that. The bowl is not pre-treated. So I'll be breaking that in tonight. It is a balsa system, I believe. So I'm going to take this off. Yep, there's a little balsa right there on the end of this. So you can kind of see. Put this back on. That is a pretty pipe. So I'm going to smoke this tonight. I wanted to show you guys the unboxing because I definitely wanted to use this, but the next time you see this, this will have been smoked. By the way, it came with a pipe sock. Ooh, a really nice pipe sock. Very nice. Some instructions. Little thing on the Savinelli pipe collection. Yeah, really cool. Set that to the side. Some balsa system things. You know what those are. How to properly smoke a pipe. Some instructions. All right, so this is my award for being the Humanities Instructor of the Year. And I am very pleased with this. This is gorgeous. I'm very happy with this. Look at that. Just wow. All right, so I'm going to do an unboxing video. I have another pipe coming as well, so I'm going to put this in there. All right, so I hope you liked the unboxing. I actually did not get to smoke the pipe that night. It was way too windy. For you new pipe smokers out there, if you didn't know, if you take a new pipe with an unfinished bowl out and it's very windy, you could damage the pipe. So you have to be very careful. So it was way too windy for me to smoke the pipe. So I'm actually going to get to smoke it on a Crack in the Tin episode. I was able to wait. I waited, everybody. I decided to just wait, and I'm going to smoke it for the first time tonight. Now, I'm going to have to be honest. The tobacco that I'm reviewing tonight is Esoterica's Margate. Yes. So, Margate, if you could tell, I've already opened it. Now, the Margate, I couldn't wait. I just had to smoke some of it. I'm going to spoil this one for you. Man, Margate has to be one of the best English blends I've ever had. Now, I know there are going to be a lot of naysayers out there, and a lot of you guys are probably going to say, well, there's tons of stuff better than Margate. Well, I haven't tried that yet, and I'm going to get to it. But as of right now, Margate, and I'm an English blend fanatic. I love English blends. Margate, at this moment, I've been smoking this for about 4 days, I think. Margate has to be my new favorite English blend. And that's one of the reasons I think it's so hard to get a hold of. It and Penzance. I have not tried Penzance yet. But, so we have Margate here. Let me read the description here. It says, utilizing the finest whole leaf and traditional production techniques, we take pleasure in presenting a wide variety of premium pipe tobaccos for your enjoyment. And this is the best full English tobacco, Margate, from J.F. Germain & Son, Esoterica Tobacco. Sorry, Esoterica Tobacchiana. Sounds way cooler. All right, so let me read you a description that I found here online. A classic English mixture done in the old style of many of the fine tobaccos that have now disappeared from the marketplace. Choice Orientals and generous quantities of premium Cyprian Latakia keynote this rich, full-bodied blend. A well-balanced, robust, and eminently satisfying smoke. And I have to tell you, I agree with all of that. It is very satisfying. So in here we have Latakia, Orientals, and Virginias. And I'm going to show you the blend really quick. All right, it looks to be very fine. It's called a shag cut. Really fine, teeny tiny pieces of tobacco. And the odor is just that sweet, smoky English. That's exactly what you want from an English blend. So great. So today, I'm going to break in the new Savinelli 320 Lancillotto, my award for the humanities thing. A lot of you are going to say, well, you're not going to be able to taste the tobacco. I've been smoking it for the past 4 days. I promise you, I've smoked this in pipes that I've broken in completely. I love it. And I think I want to make this an English pipe. I want to make it an English blend pipe. So I'm going to start this pipe out with some Margate. So let's load up a bowl. And I think I'm going to do what they typically say to do with brand new pipes. I normally don't do this. I normally just fill them up and smoke them all the way down. New pipes. But this one was, for me, a little more expensive. You know, I paid a little bit for this one, so I think I'm going to fill it halfway, and this is a very unfinished bowl. It's just wood in there. I'm going to fill it halfway and smoke it down for the first few smokes. I think that's how I'm going to do it, to help build that cake in the bottom. All right, I got to be very careful. This looks like it could be very susceptible to rim char, which I would not like on my brand new pipe. So let's see what we got. Well, I guess you gotta break her in sometime. So here we go. Charring light tastes great. This is just a treat. I can't even begin to express to you guys what a treat this is to have my brand new Savinelli Lancillotto pipe with some Margate in it as the first smoke. This is just a treat for me, and I hope you guys are having as good a time as I am, because this is great. the draw on this pipe is just fantastic. Really, really good. Sometimes with the 320s, I don't know if it's how they drill them, but sometimes they could, the draw can be a little weird if they get it wrong and you get the balsa in there a strange way. Sometimes the draw can be a little off. With this, just great. Yep, tasting tasting the tobacco first, but after that I'm tasting a little bit of the wood being charred, which is typical. I'm telling you guys, 320, that's my shape. 320 is my shape. This is my shape. Tomorrow I have another 320 coming in. Like I'm a crazy person with them. When I say the 320 is my spirit animal, I'm not kidding. I can't stop buying 320s. Somebody help me stop. I don't want to stop. I want to keep enjoying buying 320s, so don't stop me. So how did I get a hold of the Margate? Well, I was lucky at my brick and mortar here, John David Cole down at the Country Squire. They happened to have some. I just got lucky, very lucky, and I happened upon an 8-ounce bag of Penzance and an 8-ounce bag of Margate. And I couldn't be happier. Great people down there. I'm going to put a link in the description to the Country Squire online. You should go check it out. Yes, I am in heaven at this very moment. A little coffee. Something about that cut, that shag cut in this Margate, makes it burn really well. It's not too wet. It's great. The only problem I see now is I'm addicted to this stuff, and it's really hard to get. It's really hard to get your hands on Margate, Penzance, Stonehaven, any of those Esoterica blends. It's very hard to get a hold of them. Something else I was noticing about these, no nicotine warning. That's great. What do we need a nicotine warning for? I know, I get it. But look, there's no nicotine warning anywhere on this bag. Also not needed. Must have to do with the import, the way it's imported or something. That may be why it's so hard to get. I don't know. So anyway, I'm going to smoke the rest of this pipe. So this Saturday, I'll be doing a musical tobacco review on Hearth & Holmes Black House. I'll be doing a musical tobacco review on Margate in about 2 weeks. So stay tuned for that. There are some changes to the channel now. I have a Git Tuesday or a Guitar Tuesday. People have been telling me that I'm not putting enough guitar in the channel, so I'm going to try to inject a little bit more guitar in the channel. I did some videos up in my studio of me playing a few pieces that I arranged, so I'm going to upload them in hopes that you guys like them. So if you haven't seen it, go check it out. Let me know what you think in the comments. So remember, love life. Smoke a Lancillotto 320 by Savinelli, and keep on picking. I'll see you next time. All right, you made it all the way to the end of the video. Congratulations! You probably heard I do something called musical tobacco reviews. I'm gonna put one of those right there for you to watch. Then I also do this new thing called Guitar Tuesdays, or Git Tuesdays, where I play a piece. I'm gonna put one of those right there for you to check out. So if you like what you've seen here, press the like button and subscribe. Look forward to seeing you on board the channel. I'll see ya. Yes.